When a game shares many similarities with another that came before it, it can be difficult to develop a clear-cut identity without drawing too many comparisons. This is especially true when the similarities are shared with a very well-known IP that's been around for decades. This is the case with Anodyne, yet it doesn't have the issue of standing out, even though it's clearly heavily influenced by The Legend of Zelda. Anodyne uses certain elements from the early 2D Zelda titles while managing to put its own spin on them, which ends up resulting in a unique adventure that stands out on its own merit. Anodyne will have you journeying through the subconscious of this playable character, Young, as you fight your way to a mysterious entity known as the Briar, at the behest of a village elder named Sage. I often felt like the quest's main narrative provided little motivation, and I was just advancing because I was told to. Young's journey never really feels as important or as grand as Sage makes it out to be. The game's plot doesn't contain the clearest of narrative threads, and much of the story is left to interpretation. However, the themes that present themselves through the dialogue found between the main story beats are easier to grasp. The conversations tend to be humorous and witty, but Anodyne also touches on topics such as friendship and loneliness throughout the game in a few subtle and serious ways. The lack of more direct storytelling actually turns out to be beneficial in some ways, as it helps create a constant feeling of unease tonally when roaming from place to place. There's an eerie feeling that's ever present throughout the game, as if something just isn't quite right when it comes to the game's characters and its world. You don't need to venture to all four corners of every location, but this feeling of mystery will fuel curiosity and drive you to explore in order to learn more about the game's world. Even though the reason for the quest may not be easy to understand, the game makes sure that players will enjoy the journey enough to play first and ask questions later. Anodyne starts players off in an area known as the Nexus, which is a location that is full of warp gates. Armed with only a broom and your wits, you'll venture out into the world through the only active gate in order to overcome any obstacles that appear between you and the Briar. Your only means of defense is a basic short-range poke with your broom, but Young will soon acquire new skills that allow for different combat and traversal options. There's very little hand-holding in Anodyne, and you're given a good amount of freedom to venture wherever you see fit, barring a few locations that require new abilities and items to reach. The Nexus gates only return you to locations that you've already found once you locate the corresponding warp platforms in the world, but they're well placed so that you can avoid any unnecessary backtracking. There's a surprising number of areas to explore, each with their own distinct visual style and musical theme. These zones can range from bright plains and beaches to ominous forests and towns. Some areas have striking looks that are completely different in relation to the rest of the game, which only adds to the creativity and mystery. The variety found within the numerous locations ensures that the game never feels dull, visually or sonically, and searching for the collectible cards in each locale provides a good reason to see most of what each have to offer. Gameplay in Anodyne is an easy and uncomplicated affair during the first hour or so of play, but the level of challenge begins to ramp up at a perfect pace as you move from one area to the next. As Young gains new tricks, so do his enemies. The escalation of difficulty in the dungeons is especially masterful, as the game continues to add new twists to combat, puzzles, and the top-down platforming. More specifically, the puzzles become much more creative. There's added variation among enemy types, and the 2D landscape itself becomes a true obstacle as the game goes on. Dungeons become increasingly more skill-based, and clearing them can feel like a triumph. By the end of the game, the combination of smart enemy placement and landscape hazards became maddening to deal with, but ultimately rewarding to overcome. While all of this well-thought-out progression is certainly a positive, there's one flaw that can rear its head from time to time. Young has the ability to trivialize certain enemy encounters as he gains more health through the collection of cicadas. These red insects are comparable to The Legend of Zelda's fairies in look, but have the same function as the series' heart containers. If you explore enough, you'll encounter these cicadas regularly, and the added health can allow players to take up to 16 hits in combat, while most enemies can be defeated in around 3. The game is still clever enough to create tough situations, no matter the size of Young's health bar. But using brute force by completely disregarding enemy attacks is an option for those who go cicada hunting. Anodyne contains a total of 16 achievements, and they're easy enough to obtain for the most part. There is one, however, that'll add a few extra hours to your playtime. It requires you to complete 100% of the game in under 3 hours. I completed the game in about 6 hours, with 37 out of 48 cards collected. But even if I had known where to go and what to do at every instance, finishing the game in under 3 hours at 100% completion would prove pretty challenging. Anodyne is definitely reminiscent of 2D Zelda titles, but it manages to not be bound by comparisons, as it offers a fresh and welcome take on this style of game. Because of this, I'm giving the game 4 stars out of 5. It uses certain ingredients from games that influenced it, while also injecting its own brand of humor, presentation, and gameplay into the mix to create an experience that fans of the genre should not miss out on. If you enjoyed the video, give it a like, share it around, and be sure to subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.